Right, hi guys, welcome to a new episode. It is a real pleasure to be back after many months without publishing any new content. I did publish a video a few days ago, but it was an old one. Still got a few old videos that I didn't publish yet because I've been a bit lazy in editing recently. Also got some new stuff that just came in. So really excited to show you the new stuff and the older videos we'll see later. Let's take a closer look to the actual knife. This is a dagger, a folding dagger, obviously, made by Ken Steigerwald. Now, I have already reviewed some of his knives in the past, so just go and check the archives if you are interested. Let's quickly go through the specs of the knives. Weight, size, materials. You often ask me all these information in the comments, so let's start with that. Handle length, we are looking at 11 centimeters. Blade length, we are looking at 8.5 centimeters. And the overall length is 19.5 centimeters for a total weight of 122 grams. As you can see, it's a backlock. And talking about the materials, we've got a steel handle with mother-of-pearl inlays, two inlays on each side, a Damascus inlay that I think was made by Mike Norris, could be Devin Thomas, but I would rather say Mike Norris, and I know he often uses his Damascus. We've got beautiful gold pins on this Damascus inlay that are all of a different size. Gold on the backlock. Really love the way he does these. Very unique. Gold pins on the spring. So that's pretty much it for the materials. Blade steel, not quite sure. It's not my knife, I'm sorry. And the collector doesn't remember. We've got gold again in the blade for the pins and for the inlays. So very interesting design in my opinion. I think it's really hard to make a nice dagger that looks very different to everything we've already seen. As you have to keep the symmetry, you have an additional constraint to the creativity. So not only it is a knife and it has to have a blade and cut, it's also a folding knife. So you can't do everything you want in the design, but it's also a dagger. So it's very easy to make something that looks like something that has already been made in the past. But I think Ken, with his skills, really managed to make a very interesting dagger. You have a perfect symmetry. The only thing that it doesn't make it symmetric is the backlock part and the two little pins that are just there. Other than that, perfect symmetry. Very, very cool design. So, let's have a closer look to the handle. So, black mother of pearl. Very nice shades of color. Contrast nicely with the Damascus. And what I absolutely love that Ken often makes is the filework that is on the spring. Very Art Deco style. Just like the whole dagger, with again lots of little pins with different sizes, and I really love the way it is all hand rubbed, just like the rest of the steel parts, but these little grooves there are polished. So just on this little flat area, we've got a lot of work involved. Very, very cool. Absolutely beautiful grinding. Very, very well made. Sorry for the dust there. With nice crisp edges where the Ricasso is. Something that's really hard to do. That are completely parallel with the shape of the handle. So it makes a really nice effect. We've got this gold inlay that is inserted in a groove that is actually black. Not quite sure how he gets this black color, but probably it's kind of raw from the heat treatment. And he probably adds another treatment to it to get it even darker. Really enhances this yellow color from the inlay. Gorgeous. Really gorgeous. On the inside, Kin Staggerbolt as usual. So yeah, that's it. As usual guys, hope you enjoyed it. Please leave a like if you did, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.